What's up, guys? This is Dr. Feelgood here, coming at you with another video. I do welcome you guys and thank you for listening in. I found out something today, something that I've seen has pissed off a few people that I know. But I saw the Mortal Kombat 10 trailer and I was pretty, excited about it. I am a Mortal Kombat fan. And I played almost every one of them, and I own a few collector's editions at that I hadn't even opened. Now, what's a fighting game? I'm thinking to myself, this is more like going to hit every single console, last gen and current gen. But when they announced it for everything under the sun, last gen and current gen, except the Wii U, I couldn't help but be extremely pissed at Warner Brothers. And here's the reason why. The Wii U is more than proving itself a powerful console. Significantly more powerful than the last gen. And it's comparable, and in some ways even more powerful, or should I say more capable, than the current generation, the 8th gen. Yet they still make these dumbass decisions. Now, even as a developer, you porting a game to multiple consoles, even one console only sells 30,000, 50,000, 100,000 copies, you're still profitable because you're not spending tens of millions of dollars to port that game over to a different console. You're just basically translating the code. Now, I'm not a programmer, but I'm pretty sure that not that much effort goes into it. Basically, translating and interpreting the code. However, this is bullshit, hands down. I don't curse much, but this is complete bullshit. So, to Warner Brothers and all these other would-be third-party companies out there that have these amazing, logical reasons for not bringing games to the Wii U, games we know that would be they can easily support it, to hell with you. I don't want your broken product anyway. You can't even optimize your own damn engine. That's just a god honest truth. Whenever you release a game for these other consoles, it always comes with a patch. You can't even optimize your own damn engine or games for the consoles you are putting the most effort into. So, you can keep that shit. Just go ahead and keep it. It doesn't make any damn sense as a developer, but hey, I understand. Times have changed. You guys are being paid, more than likely being paid under the table by Nintendo's competitors to give these developers reasons. Let me back up. You're basically being paid under the table to not bring your games to the Wii U. I'm not saying that Microsoft approached you and say, here's $10 million for you not to port it to the Wii U. I'm thinking that they're paying you so much just to have the privilege of having your game on their vacant systems that they're probably almost bankrolling the entire project of making the game. Let's say the game costs you $100 million. I'm pretty sure, these companies, both Sony and Microsoft, are each paying you $10, $20, $30 million just to make sure you port it to their consoles. And probably a little bit extra to make sure to give a lame-ass excuse not to bring it to the Wii U. But you can keep that shit. Because Mortal Kombat 10 is not going to outsell Smash Bros. 4. Not even the DS version. I can guarantee you. Mortal Kombat 10 may not even outsell Street Fighter 4. I love Mortal Kombat. It has its own calling, but at the same time, it has to compete with Soul Calibur, Tekken, Street Fighter. In all honesty, you're a good game, but you have a lot of competition. It is stupid for you not to bring it to every single system, especially when the Wii U is not a system that has tons of fighting games available. You could easily garner sales on a Wii U just because there are not many other fighting games out there. But hey, keep your shit. Just like I didn't purchase your damn Arkham Origins because it wasn't shit compared to Arkham City Armored Edition. So you keep that shit. At best, I may rent your shit. But anyway, this is Dr. Feelgood. You guys be good. Have fun. Keep it gaming.